There's plenty of instructions online on how to remove the screen from an iPad 1. For some reason, I found this quite difficult. It didn't help that the glass was already broken and seems very ready to splinter. Safety glasses are definitely recommended. After a bit of effort, I've got a nice screen and I've got a couple of speakers. I'll save the speakers for another project. There's not really much more that can be salvaged, the batteries are completely dead, and that just leaves the motherboard, which can't really be used for much. This particular screen is an LP097X02. Looking on eBay, we find plenty of driver boards that will run this LCD and take an HDMI feed. I've purchased one of these boards, and it comes with some buttons and an IR receiver. We probably won't need these. It comes with a driver for the backlight, and it comes with the main video board, which has an HDMI, VGA, and composite inputs. Hooking this all together actually gives us a working display. I'm pretty pleased. So I've got a project in mind for this display, but first I'd like to thank PCBWay for sponsoring this video. PCBWay offer PCB production, CNC and 3D printing, PCB assembly, and much, much more. They're great to deal with and offer excellent quality, service, and value for money. Check out the link in the description. So, onto the project. I built this magic mirror some time ago, and I used a Fire tablet for the display. I'd like to liberate the tablet and replace it with the Pi Zero and my salvage screen. My magic mirror software is actually pretty simple, it's just a web page, so I'm planning on running a web browser in kiosk mode. I know there's lots of great options for magic mirror software, leave your suggestions in the comments. I've got some interesting plans to do some fun stuff with the camera, but I think that's for a later project. So to set up the Zero, I've burnt the SD card with Raspberry Pi OS. I haven't got a keyboard or mouse to connect, so I'm going to enable SSH by creating an empty file on the SD card called SSH. I'll also get it to connect directly to my Wi-Fi by creating a WPA supplicant file and filling it with my Wi-Fi details. Once it's all wired up, it actually works. The Pi is talking to my new screen. There's a couple of steps to finish off. We'll SSH onto the machine and start the config tool. First thing to do is to set the correct screen resolution. Currently there's a black border around the display and I want it to fill the entire screen. I'll also switch on VNC while I'm here so that I can connect to the GUI. We'll need to change the host name. I've already got a Raspberry Pi on my network and at the moment they'll be conflicting. And then the final thing I want to do is change the screen orientation to portrait. This is done in /boot/config.txt and we just add a line display_rotate=1. Quick reboot and we're now able to connect using VNC. I'll finish up the setup and then I want to install some software to hide the mouse. The worst thing to do would be to have a magic mirror with a mouse cursor right in the middle of it. I'm going to use an app called Unclutter and I'm going to add this to my .bashrc file so it runs on startup. Final step of our setup is to auto-start the Chromium browser in full screen mode. To do this, we just create an auto-start file in .config lxsession lxde-py, and we add the command to launch Chromium browser in kiosk mode and point it at our magic mirror URL. With this finished, we now boot straight into our magic mirror. Let's move on to the actual mirror upgrade. I need a way to power the Pi. Initially I was thinking that I could just tap off the 12-volt supply for the display board and feed that into the Zero's regulator. But reading up on this, we find it actually has a very limited voltage range, so it won't work with 12 volts coming in, we'd probably actually blow it up. My second plan was to take a feed from the video board. Unfortunately this only has 3.3 volts available. The Pi is pretty interesting. It actually needs a 3.3 volt and a 1.8 volt rail to work, so we can't just feed in 3.3 volts. We need to give it 5 volts to its regulator so it can generate both the voltage rails. Fortunately, I've got one of these buck converter boards, and the video board also has a handy 12 volt power output, so I've wired this up and we get a nice 5 volt. So it works pretty nicely, we've got a good supply for the Zero. Let's get everything assembled. I'm taping over the edges and covering the rear of the LCD to prevent light leakage. To provide some structure, I've got some craft cardboard and I'm cutting insets into this for the circuit boards so they don't protrude too much. Gluing this onto some stiff card provides a bit more structure and also provides a nice dark background to make the two-way mirror work. Final assembly is a bit of a bodge job. There's definitely scope for some tidying up of this with some 3D printing. I've added a bit of extra black card to the back to prevent any light getting in around the edges of the screen. Initial impressions are that it works, but it's not quite as good as the Fire tablet screen. I've turned the brightness down to zero and the screen is still visible. To fix this, I'm sticking some tinted acetate sheets in front of the screen. This will decrease the amount of light being transmitted and should give us a better effect. It works. I'm pretty pleased with that. I've now got quite a flexible magic mirror. I'm looking forward to doing something fun with the camera and making the mirror more interactive. All in all, a pretty successful project. I'm happy to have salvaged a bit of tech that would have been going to landfill. I hope you've enjoyed the process. I certainly enjoyed making it. Let me know what you think in the comments. I'll see you in the next video.